today's topic. Okay, this is one part of your first chapter, chapter measurement, that portion from the physics, the very easiest topic, the easiest lesson measurement. Conversion of units is simply converting one unit to another of the same quantity. And to convert a unit, okay, class 9, so we must have knowledge about the relation between the units. For example, here is the relation of some units. You can see 1 kilometer is equal to 1,000 meters. That means 1 kilometer is equal to 10 to the power 3 meter. This is the relation between kilometer and meter. So once we have idea about this relation, then we can easily convert kilometer into meter and meter into kilometer as well. You can see other relation also. So how many centimeters make a meter? You know, 100 centimeters. So 100 centimeters make a meter. The relation between meter and centimeter is 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. For the students of class 9, this is very easy topic. And you know, 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter. So by steps, once we came to know the relation between these units, then we can link the relations of other units also. Just like, what is the relation between kilometer and millimeter? Now we have the answer. 1 kilometer is equal to 10 lakh millimeter. That means 1 kilometer is equal to 10 to the power 6 mm. So when we get the knowledge of relation between the units, then we can easily convert one unit into another. Converting the units of length, so you can see km kilometer, m meter, cm centimeter, and mm millimeter. So when we convert bigger units into smaller units, so everybody knows that we have to multiply by the relation. So converting kilometer into meter, we have to multiply by 1,000. You can see example below that. So how many meters are there in 5 kilometer? Means you are asked to convert 5 kilometer into meter. And simply the process is 5 into 1,000, and it will become 5,000 meter. So 5 kilometer consists of 5,000 meter. Similarly, so if you are asked to convert meter into centimeter, we have to multiply by 100. So how many centimeters are there in 3 meters? So we can get the answer by multiplying by 100. So 3 into 100 equals 300 centimeter. So how many millimeters are there in centimeter? For example, in 9 centimeter, so you have to find, okay, that how many millimeters are equal to 9 centimeter. And the relation between centimeter and millimeter is 1 cm is equal to 10 mm. Means to convert cm into millimeter, we have to simply multiply by 10. Yes, you can see there. And then 9 cm is equal to 90 mm. Now, so if you have to go reverse, means if you have to convert that smaller units into bigger units, and the process you have to do is opposite. So while converting bigger to smaller, we multiply. But for converting smaller into bigger, we should divide. Just like, so if you have to convert meter into kilometer, then we have to divide by 1,000. So 1,500 meter upon 1,000 is 1.5 kilometer. This way, we get the answer in kilometer if you are given the question in meter. Likewise, next we have is converting that centimeter in meter. 450 centimeter can be changed into meter by dividing it by 100. 450 upon 100 equals 4.5 meter. Very simple processes these are. You know, you are so much familiar, okay, about the converting the units of length. And finally, 20 mm is equal to 2 cm. How did we get that? So we got that by dividing by 10. So 20 upon 10 equal 2 cm. That means 2 cm has 20 mm, 20 millimeter. First step is to know the relation. What is the relation between the units? First step you have to know. Once we understand the relation, then we can easily convert. So from one unit to another unit. And the next is, okay, here we go. Okay, to convert the units of length, we found the easy process. Now, if we have to learn how to convert the units of area and volume, so we can take the reference of length. So you can see on your screen and try to understand. Here the example is given. So you have to convert that, you know, cm cube. And let me tell you, distance of class 9, centimeter cube is the unit of volume. Okay, it is the product of three dimensions: length into breadth into height. The total space occupied by is volume. And the unit of volume is centimeter cube, meter cube. And centimeter cube is the CGS unit. And here the example is showing you to convert that centimeter cube into millimeter cube. What you have to understand is, okay, centimeter cube is the product of centimeter, centimeter, and centimeter. That means if 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter, that means centimeter cube is the product of, you know, that 10 into 10 into 10 millimeter cube. Centimeter cube is equal to, okay, 10 to the power 3 millimeter cube. So we know centimeter is bigger than millimeter cube. That centimeter is bigger than millimeter cube. So 1 cm is equal to 10 mm. Then 1 centimeter cube is equal to, you can see there, that is 10 to the power 3 millimeter cube. That means 10 into 10 into 10. It is 1,000. So 1 centimeter cube is equal to 1,000 millimeter cube. And you can see similarly in case of area, the unit of area is centimeter square or meter square. Okay, so 1 cm square is equal to 10 to the power 2, that means 10 square millimeter square. It is 100 millimeter square. So after some time, we will practice the same problem in whiteboard. Now just please observe and try to understand the relation and converting. Okay, let me show another slide. So now this problem or this conversion, the students of class 9 must know. So meter per second, kilometer per hour, they are the units of velocity. So while solving the numerical problem, okay, in case of velocity or speed, if you are given the velocity in kilometer per hour, so you have to convert that into meter per second. It's very easy. We know the relation between kilometer and meter, and the relation between hour and second. Kilometer and meter, they are the units of length or distance. Hour and second are the units of time. Means now you have to convert kilometer into meter and hour into second. Then finally, we'll get the answer in meter per second. So how to convert that 60 kilometer per hour into meter per second? Very easy. 60 kilometer per hour means it is 60 kilometer upon 1 hour. 1 hour. And converting kilometer into meter means we have to simply multiply by 1,000. So once we multiply 60 kilometer by 1000, it becomes a meter. So 60 into 1000, it is a meter. Similarly, converting hour into second, we know the relation. 1 hour consists of 60 minutes. And 1 minute has 60 seconds. Means hour can be changed into second by multiplying by 60 and 60. So 1 into 60 and again into multiply by 60. Now 1 hour is changed into second. So 60 into 1000 meter open and 60 into 60 second. Now see, kilometer per hour is changed to meter per second. Now calculation. So we can cancel 0, 0. Okay, 0, 0, and then divide by the number, and finally we'll get the answer at 50/3 meter per second. And 50/3, this fraction can be changed into mixed fraction, so even you can write answer in decimal also. So here we get at 60 kilometer per hour is equal to 60/2/3 meter per second. I hope you understood. So four things we have been discussing. First, converting the units of length, then converting the unit of area, volume, and finally we also saw examples of converting that the units of speed, that converting kilometer per hour into meter per second. Okay, another example for the same kind of problem, converting 50 kilometer per hour into meter per second. Very easy. So 50 into 1000 meter and 60 into 60 second. So finally we get 13.88 meter per second. Clear? Yes. Now how to convert that meter per second into kilometer per hour? Converting kilometer per hour into meter per second, that's very easy process. And for you, I think that converting meter per second into kilometer per hour is very easy process. So we know 1 meter per second is equal to 18/5 kilometer per hour. So 1 meter per second. So converting meter into kilometer, what can we do? So converting meter into kilometer, we should divide by 1000. That means 1/1000. Now it becomes a kilometer. And how to convert that second into hour? So we know 1 hour has 3600 seconds, means 60 into 60. Means second can be converted into hour by dividing by 60 into 60, means 3600. So now 1/1000, this is kilometer. And again into 1/3600, it is hour. So reciprocal. So we'll get 3600/1000. It will be like this. This part is the conversion of meter into kilometer. Okay. And this part is the converting that second into hour. And this 3600 goes up like this. So canceling this. And finally, we will get the answer that 1 meter per second is equal to 18/5 kilometer per hour. So now, if you are given that speed in meter per second and asked to convert into kilometer per hour, and directly that you can multiply by 18/5 kilometer per hour. So once you know the relation between meter per second and kilometer per hour, so directly we can convert meter per second into kilometer per hour. You can see examples like 2 meter per second is converted into kilometer per hour by multiplying by 18/5. And you can see at last that the 20 meter per second is converted into kilometer per hour by multiplying 18/5. The answer is 72 kilometer per hour. So if you multiply 20 meter per second by 18/5, then you'll get answer in another unit, that is kilometer per hour. So I hope this is clear. let's practice in whiteboard. I'll give the questions and we'll practice together. Okay, just wait, please. So first, know the relations between the units. And then, okay, now let's do in copy, okay? So I'll give some questions in whiteboard. First, ready, please. The first question is, number one is, okay, 2 kilometer into a centimeter. This is the question. So solution is, we know relations. Directly we can write 1 kilometer is equal to, so how many centimeters? We know 1 kilometer is equal to 1,000 meter and 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. So 1,000 into 100 means 1 lakh centimeter. So this is 1,000 meter again by centimeter, 100 centimeter. It's 1 lakh centimeter. So 1 kilometer is equal to 1 lakh centimeter. So this can be written in power of 10 also. 1 lakh means this 10 to the power of 5 centimeter. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 0 after 1. So it is positive, so it can be written as 10 to the power of 5 centimeter. So once we know the relation between kilometer and centimeter, now we can easily convert. The question is to convert 2 kilometer into centimeter. 2 kilometer is equal to 10 to the power 5. See, this is the answer. So how many centimeters does 2 kilometer contain? It is 2 × 10^5 centimeter. It is 2 lakh centimeter. You understood? Just do this in a copy. It's a very simple question, but we have to understand and we have to know it. Converting kilometer into centimeter. That bigger into smaller, so we multiply by the relation. Now next. Okay. Second question is, convert, okay, 2500 mm into kilometer. This is second question's solution. Let's write the relation between millimeter and kilometer. So if we know 1 kilometer equals 10 to the power 6 millimeter, means it is 10 lakh millimeter. That means it is 1 millimeter equals 10 to the power minus 6, that is kilometer. That 10 to the power minus 6 kilometer means it is 1 upon 10 to the power 6 kilometer. Converting that smaller units into bigger units, so we have to divide the relation. So question is, converting 2500 millimeter into kilometer. So how to do this? It's very simple. 2500, that millimeter, okay, upon how much is there? It will be that 10 to the power 6. Or directly you can multiply by 10 to the power minus 6. So millimeter into kilometer. So once we divide millimeter by the relation of kilometer, now it becomes kilometer. So here it goes. Then we can write like this. Okay, answer will be 2500 into 10 to the power minus 6 kilometer. Then, so if we want to add decimal here, now decimal should be shifted to the left side. So when we shift decimal to the left side, at the time, the positive power increases. Answer will be like this. 2.5 into 10 to the power minus 3 kilometer. So minus 6, then this 0, minus 5, minus 4, and minus 3 like this. So here, the final answer is that 2500 millimeter is equal to 2.5 into 10 to the power minus 3 kilometer. In this way, we also learn to convert millimeter into kilometer. So one more example of volume. Okay, then convert, let's say 26 मीटर क्यूब इनटू सेंटीमीटर क्यूब, दिस आर द यूनिट्स ऑफ वॉल्यूम. सो वी हैव टू कन्वर्ट दैट मीटर क्यूब इनटू सेंटीमीटर क्यूब. सो यू नो द रिलेशन, व्हाट 1 meter cube is equal to, so if you know 1 meter equal 100 centimeter, and meter cube means what? It is meter into meter into meter. Then 1 meter equal, that is 1 meter into 1 meter into 1 meter. So 1 meter equal 100 centimeter, and meter cube means it is the product of 3 meters. It will be 100 into 100 into 100. And it will be what? It is 10 to the power 6. Okay, it will be like this. So 100 cm into 100 cm into 100 cm. So it will be 10 to the power 6. So 100 into 100 into 100 means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 zeros. So 10 to the power 6 centimeter cube. And 26 meter cube equal, it will be 26 into, okay, converting bigger in, into small units, we have to multiply. That came to power 6. Now it will be 2.6 into 10 to the power 7 centimeter, okay, like this. Now let me show another example of the conversion of another units. I hope this is clear. So converting the units of length and converting the units of volume, and converting unit of area, so we know that we can do ourselves. Okay, let me give another example of converting that, you know, units of time. So next question is for you is convert, okay, 3 days into, so we know 1 day equal, that is when, right? Okay, first let's go to hour. How many hours are there in 1 day? 24. Then how many minutes are there in an hour? That's 60. Then how many seconds are there in a minute? Again 60. That means 1 day is equal to 24 into 60 into 60 seconds, which is equal to 86,400 seconds. Now the question is 3 days. 3 days equal, very simple, it is 3 into 86,440, 86,400 seconds. So this. Okay. Answer is, so 2,59,200 seconds. So this way we can convert so days into seconds also. I hope you understood this one. So let me come back to you, class time. So today, so what we practice, so why, what we try to learn, did you understand or not? So I think now the students of class 9 can easily convert that kilometer into meter, kilometer into centimeter, and kilometer into millimeter, and vice versa, right? So you are also able to convert that units of area and units of volume. Okay, now one homework, please write in a copy. So if you hear me, there's one question for you. So orally I'm giving the questions. Question is convert 2 years years, okay, into seconds. That means you have to find how many seconds are there in 2 years. Now this is the conversion of units. So like this, you can also relate the units of mass. Once you know the relation between, you know, the units of mass, like a relation between kilogram, gram, kilogram, milligram, then you can easily convert from each other. Now next topic, class 9, please note down your copy. Today I'm going to write some smaller units of length. So meter, kilometer, centimeter, decimeter, millimeter, hectometer, decameter. These are the known units for you. Now let me tell you the small units, like smaller units of, number one, I can say, okay, it is micro, micrometer. This is the unit to measure small length, micrometer. It is also called micron. Micrometer. It is also called micron, and it is symbolized by mu. The symbol known as mu, MHU mu. So another small units of length is nanometer.
Excuse me, sir. We have nanometer. 3 minutes left.
It is nm. And next is picometer. It is a pm. Now finally, okay, let me write the relation between the meter and these small units. So 1 meter is equal to 10^6 micrometer. This is for your knowledge. And similarly, 1 meter equal 10^9 nanometer, and 1 meter equal 10^12, that is picometer. So among these three small units, picometer is the smallest one. So micrometer, okay, this is mu m, nanometer and picometer. These are smaller units of length, and you can easily see there the relation between the SI units with these units. So 10^6 micrometer makes 1 meter, or 10^9 nanometer makes 1 meter, and 10^12 picometer makes 1 meter. Okay. The class 9. This was for today. Ajko class ma yeti nai ho. I hope you understood the content. Today's topic was to convert units. Please take it seriously and know how to convert, especially kilometer per hour into second, meter cube into centimeter cube, kilometer into meter, and meter into centimeter. These are the important parts that you have to understand, you have to know, because these are useful for in other topics also. Bujhe bhayo class 9 aajako topic clear cha. Aba baki ko samay ma kasle kehi question cha related to measurement bhanne jun chapter cha त्यसको बारेमा कुनै क्वेसन छ भने यु क्यान रेज द क्वेसन, अथवा आज हामीले डिस्कस गरेको टपिकको बारेमा केही क्वेसन छ भने प्लिज फिल फ्री टु आस्क द क्वेसन, प्लिज रेज द क्वेसन. नेक्स्ट क्लास सो वी विल बी डिस्कसिङ अबाउट द सिस्टम अफ युनिट्स. देयर आर 4 सिस्टम अफ युनिट्स.